In this video, we're going to show you how to split cells in Microsoft Excel into columns using delimiters or a fixed width method. Use the clickable sections below to skip to each method. To use this method, you'll need to make sure that all the data in your cells that you want to isolate are separated by a delimiter. This can be a comma, period, dash, or a space. We're separating a list of names on a guest list using commas to separate first and last names. First, click and drag to select the cells you want to split. Click on the Data tab at the top, and then Text to Columns. A pop-up window will appear. From the two options, choose Delimited, and then click Next. Click the check marks next to each delimiter that Excel should use to know when to separate the information in the cells. In this case, we'll just click on comma. Make sure this check mark is used in case two delimiters are listed one after another in the cells. In this case, we have a comma followed by a space. Click Next to continue. Select if your data is text, a date, or anything else by clicking General here. Now you can choose where in the spreadsheet you want your data to appear. Type in the number of the top left cell where you want your data to start here. Leave it blank to overwrite your existing cells. Click Finish to complete. Using the fixed width method, you can separate information based on their position in the cells. First, highlight the cells with all the information that you want to split. Go to the Data tab at the top, and then click on Text to Columns. A pop-up window will appear. Choose the option Fixed Width here, and then click on Next. All the data you've selected will show in your data preview here. Click somewhere on the data preview to create a break line. Click and drag this line to a position where you want to split. You can add multiple break lines to split the cell into more than two columns. To delete a break line, double-click on it. Click Next to continue. Complete your formatting and choose where you want the new information on your spreadsheet by adding the new top left cell number here. If you want the new columns to overwrite your data, just leave this empty. Click Finish to complete.